So here we have the camera interface, and this is how it looks like. As you can see, it does have autofocus, and tap to focus is also supported. I can just take a photo of this Android robot to show you the performance of this device as far as camera is concerned, and I will take another photo without the artificial light. So we have taken both of these photos one by one. Let me just show you both of them. So this is the one which has been taken without the artificial light. One thing I can notice in this photo is that the amount of details is something which is not too high. So details are not too great in this particular photo, but color production is done nicely, although it is not the same thing which I can see on the display and over here. So it is not the same thing. The colors are being reproduced slightly differently. And over here, this photo is looking nice in terms of the colors as well as in terms of the details. As you can see, the details are nicely captured in the photo which has artificial light, although the one which does not have artificial light, the details are not that clear. But in all, I can say that the photo quality on this device as far as rear camera is concerned is pretty decent, both in low light as well as with artificial light. As far as the front camera is concerned, I can show you the interface for the front camera. So let me just talk into the front camera. So this is how the front camera will look like. The front camera is a 2-megapixel camera. It is decent enough, I would say, for the price. And I can just take a photo of mine. So I've just taken a selfie, and this is how it will look like. It does apply a certain amount of beautification, I guess, to the photo, but don't expect much from this front camera unless you have good amount of light falling on your face, especially for video calls. The amount of details it has captured is also looking good. But again, it is not too great. The front camera is decent enough, I would say, for video calls. And again, the 2-megapixel camera it has, it can do a pretty decent quality of video chat. Not a high definition quality of video chat is supported. So let's toggle to the rear camera and I can show you some more options. So we have the live photo mode over there. We have a beautification mode supported. Panorama mode is also supported. You do have support for HDR mode as well, which you can enable over here. So you can tap over here and you can enable HDR capturing. And let me just take a photo in the HDR mode as well. So we have taken the photo in the HDR mode, and this time the photo has came out to be pretty good. I would say this is brighter, this is better in terms of colors, and again details are also very nicely captured in this photo when I have taken with HDR mode. So HDR mode is good to be used on this phone, but you don't have to move the camera much in that case, unless you will have blurry shots. So camera wise, it is a decent device. Let's